Call to worship. My close companions abhor me, and those who love have turned against me. We are dispensing with the intro today, and I would ask Rosemary, please, to read Psalm 118, verses 1 to 2 and 19 to 29.
Psalm 118, verses 1 and 2, 19 to 29. A prayer of thanks for victory. Give thanks to the Lord because he is good and his love is eternal. Let the people of Israel say his love is eternal. Open to me the gates of the temple. I will go in and give thanks to the Lord. This is the gate of the Lord. Only the righteous can come in. I praise you, Lord, because you heard me, because you have given me victory. The stone which the builders rejected as worthless turned out to be the most important of all. This was done by the Lord. What a wonderful sight it is. This is the day of the Lord's victory. Let us be happy. Let us celebrate. Save us, Lord. Save us. Give us success, O Lord. May God bless the one who comes in the name of the Lord. From the temple of the Lord we bless you. The Lord is good, he has been good to us. With branches in your hands, start the festival and march round the altar. You are my God, and I give you thanks. I will proclaim your greatness. Give thanks to the Lord, because he is good, and his love is eternal.
Thank you, Rosemary. We now have our congregational response. The world belongs to God.
The earth and the sea upon
it. How good and lovely it is
to live together in unity.
Love and faith come together.
Justice and peace join hands.
If the Lord's disciples keep silent,
he is willing to shout aloud.
Lord, open our lips,
and our mouth shall proclaim your praise.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. We now sing hymn 364.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Dear loving Father, today is Palm Sunday, and as we think of Jesus riding on the back of a donkey into Jerusalem with the crowds waving palm branches and shouting loud hosannas to the King, we thank you for sending us your Son, Jesus Christ, to show us your love and to help us to see how you want us to share that love with all around us. We pray for those whose suffering and sorrow at the loss of a loved one are great. We pray for our minister and members of our congregation who are sick, and in pain for those caring for them. We pray for those who agonize over the injustice and are fighting for their lives, and to save their country and deal with dictators. Be with them, Lord. And for those who work for peace, where no peace seems possible, Lord, teach us to pray with love and understanding, to try enter into the needs that are all around us, to believe that through our prayers you can heal and bless through Jesus Christ, our Saviour and Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Angus, have you?
Yeah.
What are you singing today?
What's it called?
Sorry?
It's called Empty Grave.
Empty
Grave.
Oh, Empty Grave.
Like you can.
Wipe away those tears, child, there's no need to cry. Stand up on your feet now, lift your head up high. Don't wait till tomorrow to lay down your sorrow. Freedom is here today. Wipe away those tears, child, put down all your shame. Oh, I see an empty grave. Hear the heavens waking, angels in jubilation. That stone's still rolled away. I feel the darkness breaking. I bet the devil's shaking. Somebody celebrate. I see an empty grave. There's no need to cry. Stand up on your feet now. Lift your head up high. Don't wait till tomorrow to lay down your sorrow. Freedom is here today. Wipe away those tears, child, and put down your shame. Oh, I see an empty grave. I hear the heavens waking. Angels in jubilation. That stone's been rolled away. I feel the darkness breaking. I bet the devil's shaking. Somebody celebrate. I see an empty grave. Wipe away those tears, child. Gun, go tell the news. What started in the garden was finished in the tomb. It's all reversed, the apple, the curse. 3 days in the ground. Christ our Lord has risen. Death couldn't hold him down.
The congregation will now sing Hymn 365 and CH4, Ride On, Ride On in Majesty. for us from Luke chapter 19, verses 28 to 40.
Let's hear the word of God. The triumphant approach to Jerusalem. Jesus said this and then went on to Jerusalem ahead of them. As he came near Bethpage and Bethany at the Mount of Olives, he sent two disciples ahead with these instructions. Go to the village there ahead of you, and you go in. You will find a colt tied up that has never been ridden. Untie it, bring it here. If someone asks you why you are untying it, tell them that the master needs it. They went on their way and found everything just as Jesus had told them. As they were untying the colt, its owner said to them, "Why are you untying it?" "The master needs it," they answered. And they took the colt to Jesus. Then they threw their cloaks over the animal and helped Jesus on. As he rode on, people spread their cloaks on the road. When he came near Jerusalem, at the place where the road went down to the Mount of Olives, the large crowd of his disciples began to thank God and praise him in loud voices for all the great things that they had seen. "God bless the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven and glory to God." Then some of the Pharisees in the crowd spoke to Jesus. "Teacher," they said, "command your disciples to be quiet." Jesus answered, "I tell you that if they kept quiet, the stones themselves will start shouting." Amen.
Annette and Joyce will now give us their reflections on Palm Sunday.
Can you cast your minds back to when you used to get your sixpence, I think it was, and you went to the Saturday matinee and you watched the goodies getting surrounded by the baggies, and all of a sudden, when it looked really bad, the cavalry came over the hill and we all cheered our hearts out because we were about to have victory. And throughout all the history of the people in Jerusalem, they spent time in wars, being attacked by enemies on all sides of them, and they prayed and they believed that victory would be theirs one day. And now here we are on a Palm Sunday, and we're back to the days of the films and the goodies and the baddies, and we've watched this man that we believe is the Messiah, the Son of God, perform miracles. We've watched him heal the blind and the lame and tell us parables about how much God is with us and will help us. And on this particular day, he's riding into their capital, into Jerusalem, on the back of a donkey, but we all cheer our hearts out again. We break branches off the palm trees and we wave them. We take our coats off and put them in front of the donkey. And we cheer because we think liberation has come. This is our time of victory. We don't know what's going to happen next week, but for us, on this Palm Sunday, this is our victory. This is our day of jubilation.
I recently reread a book, being a librarian, that's a strange thing to do, I suppose. But
If you recall this series on the television, Frost with David Jason, and I got to a certain page in the book, and there he is trying to hide from Mullet, the chief inspector, and he's dodging him about. And I was laughing out loud, I could just visualise it happening. But by the time I got to the bottom of that page, David Jason had found a dead child. And I felt the tears stream down my face. And I could not believe, in such a short space of time, I'd gone from laughing to crying.
It's
kind of like Palm Sunday. I don't suppose the trees recovered quickly. All those palm leaves that were cut down, all those children cheering. Did they really understand what they were watching? But nonetheless, they cheered their little hearts out. And as Joyce was saying, he had the red carpet treatment. Everybody just took off their coat, regardless. Could have been their Sunday best, put it down in front of them, and this donkey just trod all over it, carrying the most precious cargo of all, Jesus Christ. And then how quickly everything seems to change. All of a sudden, those cheers change to the words, "Crucify him." And they released Barabbas of all people. He was free. And it was Christ that was nailed to the cross. And how the tears flowed. It's such an emotional time this week, Holy Week, starting today. And I always feel exhausted myself at the end of this week. Emotionally, because you're happy that Jesus Christ is doing what he's meant to do, but boy, is it a hard task. He's taken our sin up there on the cross. So let's hope we can live a better life after this dramatic week. Let's hope we can love our fellow man just that little bit more after Christ has sacrificed himself and God has given us Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thanks, Jeanette.
The congregation will all now sing hymn 367, Hosanna, Loud Hosanna.
Thank you.
And once more, we light our candle, the light of the world. I light this candle, and I think I've said it before in church, always reminded of the Irish tenor Joseph Locke, and the one whose song was, "It is better to light this one little candle." And it is better to light just one little candle, not to stumble in the dark. It is better by far. No, I'll stop there. Annette, would you lead us in prayer, please?
Before I read the prayer, please hold dear in your hearts Barbara Wilson and family as they've lost George. Let us pray. Dear Lord God Almighty, our Heavenly Father, we ask and pray for peace. You have gifted us this wondrous world, and yet we fail to live in peace with one another. Forgive us, Lord. We pray for the peacemakers, but we also pray for the aggressors. Enter their hearts and minds so that they may know your love. May they listen to one another and come to know your calming influence in their lives. Wash away the hatred, fear and loathing, and replenish everyone's faith. Strengthen our resolve and determination to help in any way we can to hasten an end to all hostilities, so that your heavenly peace and love may shine and reflect around us. May this season of spring be a sign of renewal to all those in authority, allowing them to build bridges. After the storms of war, let your rainbows of hope remain. We ask all this in your name, saying together the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Our final hymn this morning is CH4 again, 804, 804, You Shall Go Out with Joy.
Thank you. Please be seated.
Oh, I beg your pardon. That was just a wee bit of exercise. May God's presence surround you today as you trust him and walk in his way. May his presence within guard and keep you from sin. Go in peace. Go in joy. Go in love. Amen.